The New York Times recently published an article headlined, "Terrorists Turn to Bitcoin for Funding and They're Learning Fast." The article focused on how terrorists are using Bitcoin to circumvent sanctions and fund their illicit activities. The claim that criminals and terrorists use Bitcoin for nefarious reasons is not new. So why is this article gaining so much attention? There actually is not that much new information in the story at all. The one real thing of note is that up until now, terrorist groups would raise money by advertising their Bitcoin wallet addresses, making it super easy, barely an inconvenience to track. Gaza-based Hamas now added a feature that automatically generates a personal address for each donor, making it more difficult to track. But still, this is more the looming of a threat. The article notes that Bitcoin donations have been small drops in a bucket, equaling tens of thousands of dollars. The Qatari government alone gives Hamas hundreds of millions of dollars a year in cash. The Trump administration has seemingly taken a hard stance on Bitcoin as well. President Trump tweeted, "I'm not a fan of Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies, which are not money, and whose value is highly volatile and based on thin air. Unregulated crypto assets can facilitate unlawful behavior, including drug trade and other illegal activity." Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin says, "The U.S. will police cryptocurrencies with very, very strong regulations." U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo compared the risk of Bitcoin to 9/11. Whoa, everyone is trying to make this a story. I'm trying to make this a non-story. You know what's harder to track than Bitcoin? United States dollar bills. Cash. It's been the go-to money for criminal entities since the beginning of currency. Does Bitcoin give terrorists another avenue to raise funds? Yes, it does. Is this the biggest threat facing us from terrorists? Definitely not. They have access to way more traditional cash and weapons. And most terrorist attacks are actually quite cheap. Plus, they have other avenues of supporting themselves besides donations. ISIS supported itself monetarily for years by collecting taxes on the lands it's captured. Hey, New York Times, I know you need to sell newspapers, but cut it out with the FUD. Because all this article does is just adds to the terror.